You wanted to see me?
Yes, Paul. I really like the way you dance. No, I mean it. So I figured we'd try this again. For one thing, if you're gonna change your name, why go from a Puerto Rican one to an Italian one?
Because I don't look it. People say you don't look Puerto Rican, you don't look Puerto Rican. But I am.
So you figured you looked Italian?
No, I just wanted to be somebody new. So I became Paul San Marco.
Why did you want to become someone new?
Why? Well, I'm not exactly proud of my past.
Who is? It's what the word means, Paul, past.
Well, that might be easy for you to say.
Look, wait a minute. What made you start dancing? Your parents?
No. What do Puerto Ricans know about theater? Now they have Channel 47, but then they didn't have anything. But my father loved movies, and he'd take us all the time. He worked nights, and he'd come home, and he'd take us to 42nd Street. We'd come out of one movie and then go to another and another movie. I don't know why, but I loved musicals.
How old were you?
7 or 8.
On 42nd Street?
Yeah, it was a trip.
Go on.
I'd have to move down front, because I couldn't see. I wear contact lenses now. I'd move down front, and these strange men would come sit beside me and play with me. I never told anyone because, well, I guess it didn't matter.
Why didn't it matter?
Why? Well,
Look, Paul, if this is too rough for you, I have your picture and resume.
No, no. No. It's okay. All right. From seeing all those movie musicals, I used to dance around on the street, and I'd get caught all the time. God, it was embarrassing. I was always being Sid Charisse. Always, which I don't really understand because I always wanted to be an actor. I mean, I really wanted to perform. Once my cousin said to me, "You'll never be an actor." And I knew she was telling me this because I was such a sissy. I mean, I was terribly effeminate. I always knew I was gay, but that didn't bother me. What bothered me is that I didn't know how to be a boy. One day I looked at myself in the mirror and said, "You're 14 years old, and you're a faggot. What are you gonna do with your life?" Well, by that time I was in Cardinal Hayes High School. There were 3,000 boys there. I had no protection anymore. No homeroom could be charming and funny with the tough guys. So they'd fight my battles for me, like when I went to small schools. I liked school, but my grades got so bad. Even if I knew the answer to questions, I wouldn't raise my hand because I'd be afraid they would laugh at me. They'd even whistle at me in the halls. It was awful. Just awful. Finally, I went down to the principal's office and said, "I'm a homosexual." Well, it was a Catholic high school, and at the age of 15, you just didn't say that. He said, "Would you like to see a psychologist?" And I did. And he said, "I think you're very well adjusted for your age, and I think you should quit school." So I did, but I didn't really want to. I mean, I just couldn't take it anymore. See, when I quit school, what I was doing was trying to find out who I was and how to be a man. You know, there are a lot of people in this world who don't know how to be men. And since then, I found out that I am one. I was looking for the wrong thing. I was trying to learn how to be butch. Anyway, I started hanging around 72nd Street, meeting all these really strange people. Just trying to make friends that are like me, so I'd understand what it was that I was. Somebody told me they're looking for male dancers for the Jewelbox Revue. You know, the drag show. So I go down to audition. Now from all those years of pretending I was Sid Charisse, I had this fabulous extension. I mean, I could turn anything my first audition. And they said to me, "You're too short to be a boy. Would you like to be a pony?" And I said, "What's that?" And they said, "A girl." "What do I have to do?" "Show us your legs." "But I have hair on my legs." "That's okay, come on upstairs." So I went and they hiked up my dungarees and put on a pair of nylon stockings and high heels. It was freaky. It was incredible. And then they brought me back downstairs and they said, "Oh, you have wonderful legs." I said, "Really?" Terrific. It's so strange thinking about all this. It was a whole lifetime ago. I was just past 16. Anyway, then there's this thing of me trying to hide it from my parents. That was something. Because I had to buy all this stuff, like shoes to rehearse in, earrings, makeup. And I would hide it all, and my mother would find it. I told her there's this girl in the show, and she didn't want her mother to know what she was doing, so I was holding this stuff for her. She believed me. Well, I was finally in show business. It was the asshole of show business, but it was a job, nothing to brag about. I had friends. But after a while, it was so demeaning. Nobody at the Jewel Box had any dignity, and most of them were ashamed of themselves and considered themselves freaks. I don't know, I think it was the lack of dignity that got to me. So I left. Oh, I muddled around for a while. I worked as an office boy, a waiter, but without an education, you can't get a good job. So when the Jewelbox called and asked if I'd come back, I went. We were at the Apollo Theater on 125th Street. Doing 4 shows a day with a movie. It was really tacky. The show was going to go to Chicago. My parents wanted to say goodbye, and they're going to bring my luggage to the theater after the show. Well, we were doing this Oriental number, and I looked like Anime Wong. I had these 2 great pink chrysanthemums on either side of my head, and a huge headdress with gold balls hanging all over it. I was going down the stairs and going on for the finale. And who should I see standing by the stage door? My parents. They got there too early. I freaked. I didn't know what to do. I thought to myself, I know I'll walk quickly past them like all the others, and they'll never recognize me. So I took a deep breath and started down the stairs. And just as I passed my mother, I heard her say, "Oh my God." Well, I died. But what could I do? I had to go on for the finale, so I just kept going. After the show, I went back to my dressing room, and after I'd finished dressing and taking my makeup off, I went back downstairs, and there they were, standing in the middle of all these. And all they said to me was, please write. Make sure you eat. And take care of yourself. And just before my parents left, my father turned to the producer and he said, take care of my son. That was the first time he ever called me that.
Zach, are you ready for them yet?